Hello and welcome to my reaction to the fifth episode of Servant X Service. I keep saying X, but it's probably X in English, the pronunciation. Anyway, yeah. So last episode was pretty good. We got introduced to the president, which is who is actually a controlled plushie. I don't really like that. It's a bit too silly for a show like that, but whatever. And we got some, I guess, progression for the relationship between Lucy and Acebe, and they even ended up in a hotel together. So yeah, well, I don't think anything happened because they were drunk, or Lucy was drunk, but yeah, that was something. So anyway, episode 5 of Servant X Service. X service. Let's get into this in 3, 2, 1. Opening. Such a fun opening. Alright. Oh yeah, so we're continuing that. Everyone has close call, learn from them and maintain a healthy workplace. Fair enough. Oh yeah, I forgot. It wasn't SCB, it was a girl. Sister? Nah, a dream or something. Yeah, no, probably that his sister, but yeah, okay. For a second I was like, what the fuck? So I guess they made it seem like they went to an hotel, but nope, they went to his house. I almost did. Alright. I can see that. I mean, okay, I was like, what does she not get? Doesn't seem too bad. Yeah. This is easily an entire plot. Yeah. I like Lucy, it's pretty good. Is it going to be like my room? That's emotion. Oh shit. Okay, not as bad as me. Of course. Senran Kaguya. Of course it is. It's your turn to be it. Why is she so harsh? What the fuck? Oh, of course. Too. Okay, something as dumb as that. Not really. That's pretty retarded to get dumped for that. Oh shit. I was about to say. His girlfriend. So, one of the characters from The Office. No, it wasn't a joke. Okay. Interesting. Pretty sure she's not dumb like that, so he's not going to get dumb this time. It's always funny to see her with the a pistol stain. You know, I think she's my favorite character design wise. I think she's the cutest. Well, that's what you read. She's really great, as I said before. I think she might be my favorite character overall, outside of character design. I guess she doesn't know. Also, that's a pretty cute outfit. I didn't mention it, but I like it. Kalakai. There is an age gap. Fair enough. Oh shit, nice. Cosplay, of course. Okay. Contagio forever. Change maybe. Okay. I'm looking forward to when it's revealed. Yeah. What you mean it's not worth it? She seems worth it. She seems pretty great. Okay, let me check the age gap thing that he said. If on my enemies, maybe it's listed their age. So. Nope. Megumi's age isn't listed. And his age isn't listed either. Well, alright. I don't know. Well, it doesn't really matter. Okay, I wanted to say that this is really good. I wasn't expecting this, but I really like that there's already a romance going on. This is pretty good stuff. That definitely makes me like the show more. Yeah, Megumi. That's right, Megumi, yeah. Is really cute, seriously. I think she's my favorite, yeah. Like I said, cute voice characters and boys, and Toko is my favorite in terms of character in general. She's just very funny. Yeah, that was a good episode. It's nice that we have already like one romance already ongoing, and obviously Asabe and Lucy is what's building up. Glass, Aoge, Tai, what else? Shape of Lucy's mouse. I guess the zoom in on the poster, we can see less on the right side anyway, who the fuck cares? Yeah, that was a good episode, all that to say that. I was wondering, yeah, also if Miyoshi Saya is going to get a romance. I mean, there's no character for her, really. There's only two guys, and they both are kind of already on their paths in their own way, so yeah. I wanted to check the voice actress for the sister of Asabe. So it's Kobayashi Yu. Definitely know her. Yeah, Amazoness from Arca Under the Bridge. Let's see. Sachan from Gintama. Yeah, okay. And much more. Alright, enough. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.